let the smoke settle, and I'm going to welcome you to the first official Stoners Anonymous vlog, or the podcast. Sorry. The first one, we did a pilot episode. It was kind of a fail because we stopped recording, but it's all good. We're going to roll on to the next one. So, I'm your host, Dominic, and I'm with my two co-hosts.
Yo, what up? It's T, a.k.a. Blue Kodak, and, you know, I'm always coming at you with the facts.
Yep, and I'm Red Sarosa, and, I'm just real as fuck.
Yeah, he's not coming with the bullshit anymore.
No.
He said in the first one that he was coming with the bullshit. He has confirmed no longer that he's going to be. Yep. So today we're about to talk a little bit about our friendship and like
the millennial struggle.
The millennial struggle. We all Stoners Anonymous met pretty early in our lives, so we're really good friends. And but we chose very different paths in our lives, so we're gonna talk a little bit about that. And then, just the general, millennial struggle. I'm sure, most of you guys, if you are of the age, have been going through it. So, yeah, we're gonna talk about that a little bit.
We're gonna talk about it and how, weed has helped us.
Yeah, how marijuana has helped us.
The, Stoners Anonymous.
Yeah,
yes.
It's a huge-ass part.
Very large part.
So, who wants to go first with their story? Their post?
About
post high school, I mean, you should start it off with like how high school was to you, kind of just start off from high school, like your mindset on life and shit, I guess, and go from there. Yeah. Does any volunteers want to start? I mean, I'll start.
Yeah, you can go ahead.
You can start.
Damn. All right.
You want me to go?
No, I'll go. Fuck it. All right. So your boy Red Sarosa, young Call of Duty player, basically, throughout high school. I always, like, from elementary school up to, like, throughout, maybe, I think, like, 7th grade is when, like, I really stopped, like, giving much of a fuck about my grades. Like, I'd still, like, do, you know, pretty good. I wouldn't be a retard. All throughout elementary school, like, I was fucking cash, but I don't know what happened in 7th grade. But I don't know. Anyways, yeah, so in high school, like, I think I graduated with like a 3.
That's GPA. Pretty good.
Yeah, like
in high school?
Yeah, I had like a 3 average probably throughout high school.
That's pretty good actually.
I mean, yeah, it's not. It's like
that's honor roll technically.
Yeah, like I wasn't. But anyways, so basically, like, I don't know why, but when we all applied for like colleges and shit, like I literally like I didn't even, like, consider that I would, like, want to go to college or some shit. Like, I don't even know why, like...
Yeah.
I just figured, like, I wouldn't get any scholarships with, like, my grades and, like, my score on the ACT. So yeah. I was just like, fuck it. I'm just going to apply to, like... I'm just going to, like, meme. I'm going to apply to, like...
meme?
I don't know. Yeah. Like, I just applied to, like, a bunch of random shit. Like, Michigan. Just some, like, unrealistic shit. Like... Harvard.
You applied to Harvard?
You applied to Harvard?
I wrote it down. I don't think they...
You wrote it down as a suggestion?
Yeah.
Like, which schools are you interested in applying to?
Yeah.
Let me go with Harvard.
Harvard, yeah. Yale.
Princeton. You know, I'll get there.
Yeah.
Hey, if I had to redo it and apply to schools, I'd definitely apply to Arizona State.
Arizona State?
Florida State.
Say good party like hella.
Yeah, cause I realized that college is the most fuck it time most people will get in their lives.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
It's the first time you can be truly free from your parents. You can do whatever you want, but at the same time, it's a time where your only responsibilities are literally just school. Unless, I mean,
you work too.
If you're working, your relationship, all that, yeah, those are responsibilities.
Yeah.
But the only thing that's going to really, really matter for your future, for how your life is going to be in the future, is your schooling. And as long as you get that done, and, you know, if you need to make money, you could be working, whatever.
Yeah.
But, you know, you could find jobs pretty easily when you're in college, mm-hmm. and you can make yeah. decent money at a lot of different places. But as long as you're well in school, that's really, like, all you need to do. You don't
have yeah.
to worry about. And that's what's cool about college. You could have class 3 days a week.
Yeah.
From, like, 1 p.m. to 8 p.m. Mm-hmm. And that's it. You're chilling. So it's the first. So it's really the time where you can do whatever you want.
Yeah.
So I wish I had applied to more schools and just explore my options. I mean, I really like where I'm at right now. And I'd probably pick it again if I knew, you know, now that I know my experience there.
Yeah.
But, I'd definitely visit a couple of those yeah. schools and think about it.
I feel like
yeah, it's a huge like decision. You gotta be like way more yeah, smart about it. Like I wish I thought about it like
yeah,
hella shit more. Like I just got lucky basically and just like ended up at like a good path. Like,
yeah, bro, your program actually worked out like yeah, hella good. Like,
yeah, it worked out. I'm happy with it.
Yeah, that's pretty dope.
For all the shit talking all our school with, you know, saying about getting us ready for college, they really did not at all.
No, yeah, not at all.
They made it sound like they were like helping us with being prepared and knowing what it is and
not at
and
all
how to pick. But I feel like they don't even know how to pick.
Hell no,
they don't know what they're doing.
No, yeah, I didn't. I felt like I didn't have like any like type of guidance in high school.
And just like I feel like it's really fucked up. This like general life for us is like. Like, they don't teach us shit about, like, how to be an efficient adult, you know? Like,
yeah.
With, like, all the shit you gotta, like, you're gonna do in the real world and, like, you know, just bills, like, mortgages. Just, like the way the world actually works. Like,
they don't
tell us, like...
It's a pipeline to...
Yeah, just, like, us to be, like, workers, you know? Like
they, yeah.
It's all about the standardized exam work.
Yeah.
Or the job, or it's just all about.
Yeah.
It's all about just they really need. They need to teach us shit like that. It seems like I'm fucked. Like I'm gonna have to just hop in this world and just like make all these mistakes in order to learn like how to actually do it right.
I still don't know how to do my taxes.
Yeah, same.
Like, I can't do shit, bro.
A bunch of this insurance shit is super confusing.
Yeah.
You know, there's all this stuff. I wouldn't know how to deal with getting a mortgage.
No. And they don't even like unless you go into like a program. In college, they don't even teach you that.
I don't know, like, what my house taxes are based on. I don't know anything.
No, I'm clueless.
A bunch of shit that I'm gonna have to know they don't teach you. But I know what a derivative is. Or I take, like, a theater class. I know a lot about theater. Just because, not because I wanted to, because I had to check it off.
You know,
to take a prerequisite.
I take, like, a cinema class.
Definitely has a class. On just,
that's
like,
what I'm saying. Why can't some of the prerequisites be life?
Yeah. Just like,
how to handle life.
How to be an efficient adult or something like that.
Something, like, useful. Like, I'm not... I watched movies.
I know.
I paid to watch, like, old 50s movies just because I had to check it off a list.
And it's
not like,
I feel
it's
you.
Not like you just had to show up. No, you still got graded.
Yeah, I still got graded.
So, that's what I'm saying. This whole concept of it. They're making us... So they're telling us you have to do this. Right? And you still have to pay for it.
Yeah.
But that doesn't mean you're gonna get it. You still get graded. And the grading is not based on if you actually learn it. It's based on an exam, which
doesn't really
learning,
test
like
learning.
You're learning how to do the exam rather than like learn. You're being tested on like how well you can learn to pass the exam versus like your actual understanding.
Yeah, you're learning just like facts about something and then memorizing those facts and answering on a fucking bubble
like
sheet.
Some of the tests I've seen, like that Tariq showed me of his shit, it seems like super in depth. Like, I mean, if the test is going to like test you on like the whole process of something you would deal with your major or something, that's a good test, probably.
Well, all right, I'll say this. So being a pre-professional student, having to take all those exams. Yes, I agree with you. A lot of the exams are. And they do test you about how much you learn. But the problem lies within the fact that that grade on the exam matters so much that you start, instead of me sitting there and reading the chapter and just absorbing whatever I absorb, you know, I'm looking at the slides. No, I'm sitting there memorizing facts, just like he said, just so I can get, and so I get a grade on the exam. I'm not sitting there and actually learning.
Yeah.
When you're that stressed out and when you're that hurried to learn a bunch of information, you really don't learn. The best way to learn is just to sit there and enjoy it. That's literally the best way to learn something, is if you actually enjoy it.
Yeah.
But especially for me, like I'm saying, for someone that has to get all A's or is pressured to get all A's, it becomes way less about what I'm learning in the class. It becomes way more about what teacher is teaching it. Are they easy? Are they hard?
Yeah.
Can I get old exams? All this stuff is just...
Yeah.
It becomes way less about the information.
Yeah, the one thing that was like really sweet about my program is that I was learning, like I did three or four months in school, then 3 or 4 months at work, like constantly throughout the year, for 3 years after high school. But, like, I would learn something in school, and then you know you don't really fully understand it, and then until you like, you have to like work with it and like actually like figure it out, work and just like actually use it in a like real situation. I guess it really like makes your understanding of it so much better. I feel like the strategy of doing like a working as an intern while going to school, what you guys are doing, basically, yeah, like once you get like farther into your college, everyone gets an internship, it seems like, and that's like hella like a good way to learn if your work does implement the shit you're learning at school.
That's the other thing with that whole system is it starts to become, no, you don't wait and get an internship in whatever you want to do. You literally try to get whatever internship you can get just so you can put on your application, just so you can get a job later. I mean, no, don't get me wrong. A lot of internships lead to jobs, which is great. It's actually amazing. We have a couple of friends that are in that kind of situation right now.
Yeah.
But a lot of it, it's just... It's basically, the whole problem is basically there's so many people and there's no good way of testing every individual on all that they know and who they are as a person. Mm-hmm. So you just have to rely on a resume, basically.
You
have to rely on things that you can put on paper and say this is who he is compared to other people. Problem is, every person is different, every person learns different, every person is good at different things, but they don't have a good way of doing things.
Yeah.
You know, like, I'm a person that's good at taking exams, right? I know very smart people that are bad at taking exams, so...
Yeah.
You know, what does that mean at that point? They're literally smarter than me, and they'll probably be better, but I'm just better at taking an exam. So now, does that make you better suited? Just because my resume... So that's what I'm saying. That's the whole problem in this system. That's just what you get when you have so many people and you need so many different things to be done.
Yeah.
That's the one thing I'm really appreciative of my major, is that like everything in my major is super about just like learning it. Like, they don't want to like test the fuck out of you. They don't want to like make you memorize dumb shit. They actually want to like teach you these things so that you can actually go out and like practice these things. I'm a health science major with a concentration in nutrition, which it's like it's a pretty small major, but like there's a lot of opportunities that come with it.
Yeah, it's a pretty broad like
category. You can branch off and do a bunch of different things with it, so I like it a lot. But everything is about like super learning.
Yeah, that's
like,
really useful.
What they'll do is they'll just have, like, slideshows. They'll have people, like, actually come into the classroom and, like, speak on different things. But, like, yeah, all the only way that they, like, grade you, because they have to grade you for the university, they just, like, make you do a bunch of essays.
Uh-huh.
Like, we have exams, too, but, like, they're nothing crazy.
I feel you.
Yeah. So like it's more about
learning the actual material. Learning.
Yeah.
That's I like the like having people that work like in the industry come in and talk. Like that's probably like super helpful.
It really is.
That's like the best information you can get probably.
It really is.
Cuz like a teacher could talk about shit in a book, but and unless there's some link between it and the real world that makes sense in your head.
Yeah.
It's not going to do shit.
Mhm. The one thing that I have about it is every professor that I've had for, like, the courses that I'm taking, they're all vegan, basically.
Oh, really?
So all of them have been vegan, which they still give you, like, the actual facts of these things, but a lot of their opinions are kind of biased.
Yeah.
And I've yet to take a teacher who is not vegan.
I kind of have a similar experience with me being a sociology major.
Mm-hmm.
So I picked sociology because, you know, I took a class, I really liked it. And it was, I did, my sociology class are usually, like, good classes where they, you know, they don't really care about the test as much. It's about, do you know this stuff?
Yeah.
And that's what I really liked about it. I started off in, you know, a biology pre-med. Now I'm a sociology pre-dental, and still all those biology classes, all that stuff, it's all what I was saying earlier, it's all about the grade. I mean, my other sociology, I still have to get the grade, but it's not as much of a grind. I just have to learn the stuff and actually enjoy it, and that's what's really cool about it. But I do have the same experience in that a lot of my sociology classes, not necessarily the professors, but all the most of the kids, since most of those classes are discussion based, most of the kids are very much almost like bigots in like a liberal way. You know?
Yeah.
Where it becomes very, very one sided and they, you know, it becomes kind of extreme.
Yeah, extremely and like liberal classes.
To a point, well, it becomes the same way. It becomes like blinded. It's like that's when I think anything goes bad, when it becomes like a blind belief.
Yeah.
And something like,
and I was thinking about this the other day. It was actually today. I don't know why I said that. But like Kanye West tweeted out, he's like, I don't agree with 100% of like what anyone believes. And I feel like that, like, even though he can be like a dumbass sometimes, that's actually a good piece of advice.
Yeah.
Like, you don't have to agree 100% with someone or something. Like, you could always take, like, the opposition if you feel like that's right.
Yeah,
it comes in on, like, morals. Like, morals is, like, a crazy, powerful, like, really deciding factor of who people are.
Yeah,
because morals, you know, there's not really a right or wrong answer.
Yeah, it all depends on the person's morals that is stating if it's right or wrong.
Because people, you know, the general moral agreement that I agree with is killing people is bad, right?
Yeah.
It's something that most people can agree on.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But technically, on an animalistic, pure animalistic level, I'm sure some people could argue that killing people is not bad. And it's not wrong.
Yeah.
You know, it's just moral. Your moral is the way you grew up. It's the way you learn to think. And that's what's so crazy about humans, is every person, that's why you can't really, that's what I was saying yesterday, I don't argue with people.
Yeah.
I'll discuss things with people, but then once it starts to become an argument, there's no point.
Yeah, you're just like more pissed at each other.
Because at that point, they won't admit they're wrong, I won't admit I'm wrong, and there's no point.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But that's what I'm saying, that's when it comes to that point where you just, every person grew up differently, and they think differently, everyone's brains are different.
Right.
You can't, you know, the way you think, we tend to get stuck in, like, this is our world, everyone thinks the same as me.
Yeah.
And you don't really think about how other people are just completely different in the way they're thinking.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm very, like, I don't know, I feel like smoking weed has made me way more aware of that shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
I feel like my like friend group and the people that I've surrounded myself since, like, the area I grew up in was very diverse, that, like, I set myself up to be very, like, tolerant of other people.
Yeah. No, for real, like, me talking to, like, all my other friends about this shit, like, even from, like, remember how, like, I was telling you about how that dude when, I don't think, you and Lucas came the day after when we went up north. Like, my friend, my dad's friend that made that comment about how we were all up north, and he's just like, you with all your Taliban friends came up. Like, he said it in such a joking way, and that translates to, like, what we were talking about yesterday, actually, how, like, white people have that, like, general, just, like, when they're together and they just talk about that racist shit, like, really low key, like, they're all, like, joking about it, but you can tell they just have, like, a you know, a lower vision of them.
Low-key, when we walked up that first day to the guy, and he said the... I don't know, he said something, and it was just, like, fucked up.
Yeah.
And, like, it actually fucked me up. I was like, holy shit, I don't actually hear this shit. Like, I'm not gonna say it. I honestly don't want to hear it.
Damn. Which dude was it?
Type it out or censor it or something. You have to say this now.
I can't say it, bro.
Right, he doesn't. I don't think he wants to say it to us. He just doesn't. Like, he just doesn't even want to say it to us.
Yeah. That's how, like, I just don't want to say
it. It's a good thing. No. Okay. The reason why I'm pressing on this is because I know for a fact that this person is generally a nice person, yeah. Generally a good person. Wait. If I was to go meet them right now,
yeah, no,
they'd be nice to me.
Yeah.
Wait, did he say some shit? Because you're white, so he said some shit to another white person about all the foreign people there, right?
So it was me and Dan. We were there. Someone give me their phone,
all right.
And I'll type out what he said.
God. I got it. I'll read it.
But like, it's fucked up. And like. Yeah, he was really nice, and he showed really good hospitality.
That's what we were talking about yesterday.
But like this, I don't know. Like I just started thinking about it.
It was probably that dude that let us shoot all those guns.
It was.
Yeah. No. Okay. I don't even feel that dude's crazy. Like, oh my god. But yeah, he was like nice, but yeah, that dude was for sure like fucked up in the head.
Yeah. That's what I was saying yesterday. That's how I feel. Awkward around older white people.
Yeah, I know.
I feel like all of them think I'm just stupid, or like
that whole time I was literally waiting for someone to like say some shit. For just, some reason,
yeah.
It's just I hate that vibe so much, and the fucked up if that vibe produces like, because then I'm sketched.
Right? Yeah, yeah.
And then some people react being sketched in different ways. Some people become like more hostile. Like, I don't know.
It's no, just, yeah, for sure.
It produces a bad environment,
yeah.
That's just, like, antagonizes that person that everyone thinks is stupid.
Hey, I wanted to see what this dude wrote.
Yeah, this...
I'm so excited.
I don't know. I was just kind of shook after that.
Wait, no, I'm filling up my cup.
So this... Here. So this, is a very nice older white person. Very hot.
Super nice dude.
Super nice dude. I gotta say anything about his, personality. I personally didn't meet him. I'm just going off what he said. But when we first, my friends first went up to this house, this man said, "This gun could kill any nigger in the room."
He actually said that?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Now this man has a job.
Wait, what does that even like mean? Like, that's really like a little retarded sentence.
He pulled out like a fucking Russian assault rifle,
and
he said that, this that's gun, what he said.
Could a pistol not kill like any dude in a room? Like, what? It. All right. Yeah. No, that was just some dumb shit. No, he just said some dumb shit.
It's just a figure of speech. It's like.
It is. Yeah. For
like,
yeah.
It's like how we say faggot. Right?
Yeah, that's like.
But the thing is, we say that because we're all kind of like gamers. We all kind of grew up in.
Like, yeah, we're kind of just true, like yeah, ignorant just
from
to
Xbox
it.
Live, bro. The word faggot.
The problem becomes when you start saying that, when you start saying these things, and actually being prejudiced or actually having stereotypes. Like I was saying, this man probably does have stereotypes.
Oh, people, for sure, yeah.
100%, and he thinks of them that way. When I say faggot, I 100% not thinking about gay people.
No, I know.
I have no problems with gay people. Like I know people closely that do have problems with gay people.
Yeah.
But I personally have. Yeah, I don't care.
Like, I have no problems.
It's whatever. Yeah, if you're a cool person. As long as I can sit there, smoke a blunt with you, watch some bullshit, talk about some bullshit, we're cool. You know, it's not that deep. It's never that deep.
Like. Even through my job, I've actually met, like, a bunch of, like, cool gay people.
Yeah, dude, I'm friends with that Mike guy.
And Mike?
Is
he?
The gym with John.
Oh, is he actually gay?
Dude, he's bi. So he has a boyfriend right now, but,
Dude, hey, you're
Bleep!
That guy, I mean...
Yeah, we can just...
These general names,
yeah.
Like...
Yeah,
that really is a very general name.
Yeah, like... I felt like that was okay, but anyway, right. Like,
he knew it.
That's funny.
Yeah, shit. Whatever. Who cares?
Yeah, I don't give a fuck. But yeah, he's buying. Like, he's honestly cool. Like,
yeah.
I feel like if I was to, definitely after high school, I've gotten way more okay with like homosexual, like bi people. Like,
bro, they're regular as fuck. Like, they're not trying to hit on you.
If I was to like meet a gay person when I was like in seventh grade, it would probably have gotten like way different. I wouldn't have thought of them, like, not even because like I have a problem with like what they're doing. They just would have seemed like an alien to me or something.
Yeah.
Dude, I thought about
something. They don't teach. They didn't really teach about that in our generation.
Imagine how we feel about gay people. Think about.
Oh, like, how our parents like, feel and about
like,
it. And shit.
Like how we're still like you were just saying you were ignorant about it, right? But think about what you said down, how, oh, they're not trying to hit on you.
Yeah.
They're just trying to go on with their day.
Yeah.
Dude, think about how females feel all the time.
Yeah, bro, they're not, women, you're not sweet.
Yeah, dude, no, but, like, think about, do women get hit on all the time by guys?
Yeah.
That would be such a horrible existence, honestly, having, like,
yeah, that'd be
always
ass.
Feeling like everyone's trying to look at you and, like, talk to you.
Yeah, it is fucked.
That would be fucked.
I think, all right, being an attractive female, you definitely get advantages in life. You know, with people just being nicer to you.
Oh, and, for sure.
Maybe. And people giving you stuff. And you just have, like, an easier path. But
it's... Yeah,
I feel like I would 100% rather...
Yeah, it's, a, like, distorted today. Path. It's not, like, what life really is.
I don't want to go through life, you know, like I'm being looked at. Like, I'm giving... Like, I'm given an advantage because of something, you know? Like, if I'm given an advantage because I'm charismatic, for example... That's not, you know, that's cool.
Straight.
That's cool. I'm charismatic. People like me. That's cool. But if people like me solely because I'm attractive, that's
I know.
That would suck.
No,
it's like having feeling like
you don't actually like
being
that person.
In like alleyways, like just like I walk at night with no regard.
Yeah.
No. No fears.
I'm not gonna lie. Where I live sometimes. If I'm walking and I see someone's looking kind of sketchy, I take a headphone out, right? But I'm thinking, you know, most likely nothing's going to happen.
Yeah.
And I think as being a male, pretty physically fit, that would be able to take on most people.
Yeah.
Now, being a female, I don't even know how scared I would be.
Yeah.
That would be the most.
Yeah.
That's an existence. That's what's fucked up about today's world. Like, if this was thousands of years ago and we were still, like, in the forest and shit, this would never be, I mean, you'd be scared of, like, tigers and shit.
Yeah.
But not just other humans. I think it's so sketchy not knowing. Like, if you see a tiger and you're in the woods, you know you want to avoid this motherfucker. If you see him, it's blood, right? But if you see a person, imagine not knowing what they're thinking or what their intent is. And you're someone that can't defend yourself. And that people... that's a scary...
Yeah, no.
So
honestly,
we feel awkward about it. Well, not me, but people feel awkward about it with gay people. Like guys feel awkward about gay people. Like, oh, like are they gonna try to hit on me? When at the end of the day, it doesn't actually matter. It doesn't actually happen like that. Imagine being someone that people are like that towards all the time.
Yeah.
And that can be like overpowered. That shit's fucked up.
Yeah, it really is. It's but like, I've noticed it at like the gym too. Like, these people are just trying to fucking work out. And, like, dudes will just literally come up to them and, like, waste their time for, like, 5 minutes. And it happens, like, multiple times. That would be the most annoying fucking thing ever.
And it's annoying because everyone's acting so nice, so you can't just be an asshole. Because then you'll just be known as a bitch.
Yeah, exactly.
You don't want to be the bitch, so you have to be nice. And people will come up to you and just bullshit talk to you because they just want to be cool with you.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, happy seeing them at the gym. Occasionally, someone will just look at me because I have an afro or something. And just like look at them and I just watch whatever. You know, moving on with my day. No one ever talks to me. You know, it's cool. Even on the basketball court, if someone tries to talk to me, I could literally just not even take my headphone out and just wave my head no and move on with my day.
Yeah.
That's it. No one really gives a fuck. I'm invisible most of the time.
Yeah.
Except when I go into a room full of white people and I don't feel invisible anymore.
For sure.
That's when I feel all this shit we were talking about earlier.
Yeah.
But
sheesh. Overall, like, what were you going to say, like, that compared to a girl? Like, be invisible and shit.
Yeah.
Like
no, hell no.
Unless she's, like, her entire environment is just a bunch of other girls.
No, because girls with girls are still the same way. I feel like they all...
Yeah, they all just judge the fuck out of each other.
Because think about it. If you're an attractive girl, everyone's looking at you, right? All the guys are trying to talk to you.
Yeah.
All the girls are, like...
Yeah. It's weird.
Either like, hating or like, you know, it's whatever. It's just like a weird, it's not a real environment.
Right? It's weird. Like some people hate it and then envy it.
Exactly. And think about if you're ugly, still all the guys are looking at you like, ew, like what is this? Like, you just have all these people looking at you like,
yeah.
Like what the fuck?
Yeah. Like you're not even like in their way. They're just like, oh.
Yeah, exactly.
Dude, that is so fucked up.
So I feel like life as a, we are as a male.
Honestly, yeah, dude, we made it, honestly. Oh,
damn, I well, said your name. We're going to bleep that out.
Hey, fuck. No, yeah, I know. I'm very unlike. That's also I'm like prime. Invisible. I'm prime, like, human. Like, are, most capable human right
invisible.
Now. Like,
you are 100% invisible.
Yeah. No, I feel you.
Yeah.
Nuke, but.
Hell yeah.
I think Sarosa. I guess because the environment that you're in, too.
Well, yeah, true. Yeah, like,
super environment.
I'm
super invisible. You're like, hella.
I know, I'm so like
American.
Yeah.
You would literally be the person that most people would think like, oh, he's probably like a Trump supporter that's racist.
Yo.
Like, people would literally probably think that of you from just what you do.
Yeah, like if they were to see me from like and we're, third yeah. person.
Yo, if I'm being like 100%, I'm not really around that many white people.
Yeah.
Like I honestly don't encounter that many white people.
I mean, same. Like where it's I am. Literally just like where I work.
Yeah,
that's literally like
that's the way
it put me in a whole like another world.
It's yeah,
and that's like, why I gave you as an example.
Yeah, like my work is like, it's there's not that many white people.
Yeah,
it's all like just like yeah. very multicultural.
It's
not
literally.
It's like everything.
There's this one black dude where I work actually. This guy is like he's our shipping. He's in our shipping department. He like. Goes gets shit from the UPS guy and drives
yeah.
like the forklift trying to grab shit. But this dude, he's like the only black guy in like the whole shop, and like it's I feel like honestly like I just feel like I'm like obligated to like help defend this guy against these other people
yeah.
because like I mean most of the guys are cool. Like honestly, like all the dudes there, it's really weird like the way these guys work. Like honestly, if like one of the more ignorant like younger fucking idiots like like this guy Dustin for example, he's like 30 but he's like 14 in his head, he'd probably go to the black dude and just say some like retarded racist shit just like that. But like these other older guys would probably defend the black guy against Dustin. But if I was to just be chilling with like two other of them, they would say some like low key racist shit about a black guy, but they would defend him. It makes no
dude,
sense, you
it's
know.
The crate. That's literally the problem, right? There.
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
A bunch of, those were all the people that were hiding that they're about to vote for Trump. Those were all people standing in line, looking all sketchy.
Yeah.
Because they were going to vote for Trump, but they didn't want to say it. That's why so many. That's why he won. Because all those people didn't want to say it because a lot of these people knew. A lot of people know that he that Donald Trump is. Kind of racist. He's kind of sexist.
He's like the guys I work with.
Like, but he's exactly like them. Yeah. So they relate with him. They're like, "Fuck yeah, we want this guy. He's talking shit
yeah.
to all these people." Because, hey, honestly, if there was someone that was kind of ignorant, but they were like, if Schoolboy Q ran for president,
like,
what? He would just be ignorant or like the game, some shit like
the that. Game.
They would want some like good shit to happen. I would agree with all they're saying, but they would be ignorant as fuck. They would be like, fuck you, you're wrong.
Yeah.
You're, you know? They would trump it out, right? So that it just happened that Trump, you know, being a conservative,
he's the white schoolboy Q.
It's a little easier. It's a lot easier to be like that. Because
yeah.
a lot more white people are going to relate to you, and that's all you need is more people to relate to you. Trump didn't go to states he knew he was gonna lose. You know, he didn't go to a lot. You know, he didn't spend a lot of time in California, New York, all that, because he knew all these people are
woke.
Yeah,
that's why he lost the popular vote. You know, more people
are woke
in numbers.
Yeah,
voted against him, but it's just
which is sort of a good sign.
The way voting works in America. With electoral votes and all that.
Yeah.
States, you know, certain states don't get as many.
I don't like that. Why the fuck should there be electoral votes? Like, do they have to
okay.
do with like?
Okay, I can't agree with you.
Well, I'm not stating. I'm literally asking.
Okay, so
you know?
Basically, it's the whole concept of. Well, okay, I don't really understand the whole concept completely. I'm not gonna lie to you, but what I'm gonna tell you is the reason. It's the same reason why. The Congress, for example, has like has each state has like a different number of congressmen, right?
Yeah.
So basically, electoral votes. What it does is, so I don't know, random state, Omaha. It's not a state.
Some shit. They should just delete that
Idaho, right?
Yeah.
Idaho has a lot less people than California, for example. It's the same size, right?
Yeah.
So it's like a ratio. So California would, for example, I don't know at all, but
that makes sense.
So because it's just like because in New York, there's like millions of people in a small ass place, as opposed to big places that people are spread out.
Yeah.
So they still like so New York would still get like 4 votes, but in the other state, it's the same size, it has less people, would get like 3
votes. So it's really a compensation to like. Size, match with the population it's but like why I mean if they're gonna go by that why not just go by the total population
because they take into account like alright these people in other states every person owns a bunch of land right so a bunch of land should count as a couple human beings as a you know they just like it's like a it's not an example but it is, but it's basically a ratio of people to land mass
alright.
And in a way, it is correct. Actually, I agree with how like it's kind of split up. But it's just, but at the same time, there's a lot of states that are super big that get votes, that get like, you know, more electoral votes.
Yeah.
Don't have as many people, but all the people in there are like farmers and shit, and they're all just like white people.
Dude, I feel like when they decide the amount of electoral votes each state gets, it's literally just a bunch of dudes in a room like California, bro, like I feel like they should have like 20. Like I don't know, I feel like I doubt they have some dude like doing the math, like it's probably literally just like they are so impactful on this country, like we gotta give them like 22, this is just like or some shit
that could happen.
That's
I'm not really sure.
I mean, maybe
it's a hard way. It's kind of.
That's just a guess. Like,
yeah, I'm not very good with like this government stuff.
Dude, yeah, I don't know
to,
shit.
I try to take myself a little bit out of it, just because there's so much bad that comes with it. I just don't. I don't want to be like a hostile person.
That's literally half the reason I didn't vote, was because like I know I don't know anything.
Hey, but that's what's gonna happen next time. Is the only.
But that's bad though.
One of the main reasons he won is a bunch of millennials did not vote.
Yeah.
Because a lot of us were either like you,
right? I didn't vote.
Actually, a lot of we're like you guys. We're like Trump. You knew Trump was shitty, but you also heard a bunch of people saying that Hillary was shitty.
So I didn't really know what to do.
And at the same time, you think, okay, there's no way this Trump dude, this like crazy, is about to win, right? Because I don't know. We just assume that. So then at the end of the day, we just don't end up voting, and this is what happened.
No, I had the feeling that he was going to win.
Yeah, I just felt like.
And, like, but, like, I didn't like, super agree with, like, Hillary that much, but I don't know, I just didn't know what to do. So I just, like, I'm like, fuck
either
it.
Either way, I feel like next election, it's. If Donald J. Trump wins again, I would be very, very disappointed with America. I would definitely think
moving
out, because this first time, because I already knew that there was that many white people that were going to vote for him, and I was surprised. I was still surprised, actually, that he won, but it's okay, because a lot of people did not vote. But if this next election, and also a lot of people voted for him that didn't really, like, understand what was happening, a lot of voted for him for dumb reasons that are now regretting, because what was I thinking, right? If after his presidency right now, this next election, he wins again, there's no hope. there's literally no hope.
Honestly, I will.
We can get reelected a second time.
No, he gets reelected again. If he gets reelected again this next cycle, I would lose all hope.
Honestly, I'm registering to vote next election. Literally only to vote against him.
I'm going
to
vote
like, I feel
like
any
Harambe or something.
Honestly, don't do that.
No, I'm just kidding. It's the same thing as not voting.
Did you know that?
Yeah.
Did you know that there's like literally like almost a million people just voted for
him. Yeah, no, I know. Yeah. That's why I said it. But yeah.
It was like a meme.
Yeah, like, I honestly at least should have voted for that. Like, knowing that I didn't vote, I should have at least voted for, like,
yeah,
some bullshit. But I'm curious to know, like, next, who's gonna, like, try to take down the Trump.
Just, like, I don't know. He stands for, like, so much, like, evil. And I don't fucking like it. Like, it just makes me uneasy.
Yeah.
I don't want to feel uneasy.
He's just stupid.
Yeah.
Just, like, how he...
Like, he just, like, flies off the handle. How I perceive
him just is, like, stupid. I don't even know
if he's a bad... Honestly, I 100% believe that if I was to meet Donald Trump on... But without surprising anything, just, like, on, like, a hypothetical scenario where I'm, like, on an island with Donald Trump... He'd probably be chill. Be pretty chill to me.
Yeah.
He seems like he would be a chill guy. He just seems a little kooky. He's a frat boy.
He's probably like... I feel like he's like...
He's a little kooky, man. You know, like, people are kooky.
Yeah.
You know, but those people should not be present. People that are that kooky. I don't... You know, like, people are people. People are different. A lot of people are kooky. But it's whatever. But those people shouldn't... Like I said, these people should not be present. I'm sure if he would, because I feel like he will just say shit to get people on his side. He doesn't even know what he's talking about.
Yeah.
He's not a politician, dude.
No, he's a celebrity.
He doesn't know all this stuff.
Yeah.
He's old. He doesn't want to listen and learn.
Which also contributes to me feeling uneasy. Just, like, I feel like he doesn't really know what he's doing.
He does not know what he's... No, he 100% not. Dude, he's fucking, like, tweeting... Kim Jong-un, like,
yeah,
like, strap up.
He is sub-tweeting a leader of another country.
Alright, it's so bad that I would literally not be surprised if Donald Trump came out with, like, with, like, a diss track.
Oh my god.
I would honestly not be surprised. And that's fucked up.
Same.
I would be slightly surprised. I would be excited.
I wouldn't be, like, mind blown. I wouldn't be like, what the fuck?
I would be excited. I would not be excited.
I know. I'd be like, hey. Donald
Trump. He's doing shit.
He's doing again. That's silly, dude.
This is pinnacle. So, yeah, Donald Trump is just a goon. A frat boy. Yeah, that's fucked up because that's our president and people voted for him and people still support him. And he feeds off people being stupid. He just says dumb shit. He literally just goes up there. He just says stupid shit.
Bro, he is like a child. He literally goes up there and, like, roasts people. And people will just be like, yeah, fuck yeah. Hell yeah, he's roasting Kim Jong-un.
I feel like, what if they made a law where, or made a part of the electing system that if less than 50% of people voted, then neither of them get elected because technically the majority did not vote for them.
How would that work?
I don't know.
They would have to do a re-election.
Like,
because no one would have really won.
I don't know. Like,
no, that 50% is not that much to add. That's just kind of a fair number. 50% of people... No, people don't vote. Huh.
It's probably like 10%, maybe.
No. It's way more than 50% people that vote. I feel like it probably is 50% of people. We gotta look at this.
Don't vote.
They do. I mean, 50%.
Damn.
I will vote in the next election.
I don't know. So how do you guys feel about the next whatever years? You know, as stoners, I personally feel I'm excited that weed's probably gonna be legalized everywhere within the next 10 years.
Yeah.
Maybe recreationally.
I'm just scared of, like, how the world is going to be when we're like 35 or some shit. Like, just like the way it's going now, everything just seems so unpredictable, and everything's just like the how we're talking about the millennial struggle or something. It's like nothing even makes sense anymore. Okay, I don't know. That's how I see the world.
Nothing
is straightforward, and I watched this video on Casually Explained. He dropped a video. I don't know if you know this dude.
I think so.
Yeah, he just dropped a video on
the new one. I haven't watched it
yet. Yeah, the millennial like girl versus the baby boomer or some shit. But that shit that definitely like made me open my eyes to, like, just like how different shit is for us, and like I don't know. All the people in my work, like, think I'm pretty smart and shit. Like, I feel like older people look at millennials like they're fucking, like...
They're dumb.
Like, I mean, honestly, it's like they're either, like, they think you're really smart or they think you're, like, retarded.
Okay. Yeah.
They don't... Here's the thing. Baby boomer generation before, they don't like how we conduct ourselves. But if they get to know us, like, they understand that we're smart. And most of the time, they understand that we're good at what we do. We're just, they just don't like how we conduct ourselves.
Yeah.
They don't like how we're lazy, how we go on our phones all the time.
Yeah.
Also, how we conduct ourselves. But if you're good at what you do, and we are, it's just the human nature. You know? Our kids are going to be better at everything than we are. They're going to be better book smarts than we are. Because it's just how humanity works. Especially in our exponential, like, technology growth. Mm-hmm. We just know how to do shit better. Like, every day.
Yeah, literally. Just averagely smarter.
Yeah, so our kids are going to definitely be smarter. But, so think about that. Our kids are going to be a lot smarter than us.
Dude, that's going to be crazy. Like, I'm going to have a 9-year-old that is going to, like, to do math better than me.
Hell yeah, because they're from secondary board. Yeah. Virtual reality. They're going to start... Dude, imagine your kid learning school stuff through virtual reality at the age of 2 or something, you know?
But
learning would probably become so much better.
But this has happened, like, every generation.
Yeah.
Every generation disagrees with, like, the younger generation. Like, I already noticed that I'm starting to do it. Like, I'll see younger kids and, like, shit that they'll do. And I'll completely, like, disagree with it. Like, why are they doing this? What are they doing? But, like, that's just, like, because they're not like you.
But generations...
And we, for some reason, feel uncomfortable with that.
Generations are becoming smaller. Because think about if you lived in the 1700s. Unless a big war happened and everything just changed. You, your father, and, like, you know, your grandfather kind of did the same shit.
That makes sense.
But now, since shit is changing so fast, generation becoming smaller. Because, I agree with you.
Like, it goes with the exponential growth technology.
Exactly.
That's what's making the generation shorter. Yeah.
Exactly, 100%. So,
what?
Oh, my bad. So, it's just the generation going smaller, and that's why sometimes you meet, like, I don't know, like, the generation before us don't really agree with us, and now we're disagreeing with people that are not that much younger than us. Like, you think about it, I'm 20, and I'll, like, 16-year-olds and shit are kind of stupid now.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like people were able to relate, but at the same time, that could just be because that's the age where you grow a lot.
Yeah. They could just not be, like, mature yet.
Hella older than them.
Because I am cool, like, you know, if I meet, like, I feel like the, from ages of 20, 21 to like 28, for example. I'll meet a 27-year-old. I'm cool with them. You know, like, we can vibe out. It's chill. It's a cool environment. But how crazy would it be if by the time I'm 25 or, you know, something like that, I meet a 20-year-old and I'm not cool with them. They're so much different. I think that's what's gonna happen. Generations become so much faster.
Yeah, they could.
Every generation becomes much smaller.
Damn. Hey, I mean, I actually chill, like, with my sister and her friends, like, well, her one friend, like, because she always has a bitch over. They're 17. They're both 17. I'm 21, and they definitely, I can tell they're different, like. I don't know. Like, they're less real. Like, I feel like when I was, like, when I was their age or something, and we would chill, like, and we could actually have, like, real conversations, maybe, like, but everything they talk about is literally just, like, just funny shit, or, like, just, like, roasting each other or something. Like, it's no, there's no, like, real level to it.
It's, I would say it's hard nowadays to be real. I would agree with you for, you know, there we go, because it's kind of like the social media experience, the social media world of being uber correct. You're either someone that's super, like, everything has to be this way, or you're someone that just completely does not give a fuck.
Yeah.
Or you're someone that's actually, like, a fucked up person.
Yeah.
And it's one of those three things. You can't just the kind of people we are, I think, are kind of rare in a way, newer generations. Maybe, well, we can joke about whatever, but at the same time, we know exactly what's actually correct.
Yeah.
Yeah.
In a way. I'm not going to say we're not gods or anything.
Yeah, we definitely don't know everything.
But the fact that we know that, and the fact that we can accept that we don't know shit, and that we're just fucking around, we know that we're being stupid sometimes, is what makes it so cool. Because we just, like, a lot of times, I know I'm being dumb. You know, like I was saying yesterday, the human brain is just programmed to, you know, just be dumb sometimes, you know, like, sometimes we just use stereotypes, but then yeah. You just know that that's how you're being, it's just whatever.
Yeah, if you're aware of it, then you actually know.
Yeah,
you're just being stupid at that point.
I think one of the smartest things about who I am is the fact that I know I'm not the smartest person all the time. Like, too many people think they're the smartest person in the room. And they think, you know, that. But I know that's not true all the time. I'll sit there and I'll listen to someone.
Yeah, like, I feel dumb a lot of times. Like, it's so dependent on, like, you know, the topic.
You shouldn't feel dumb, because there are, like, probably infinite things that you know hella about that I have no idea about.
Yeah.
Like, you know a lot more stuff than I, like, all of, like, the electrical things.
A different category.
I have no idea.
Yeah.
You shouldn't feel dumb. You should feel, ignorant, really.
Yeah, ignorant. Yeah,
not well educated about a topic.
I mean, that's why it's like I don't have like. I don't like. I'll feel dumb, but it's not like I have like more respect for the other person than I do for myself. I feel like I have a pretty, like I've just learned that, like, I mean, like there's so much, like everyone just, I feel like everyone's just like a really good at one specific thing. Like, with Marcel and, like, you guys, like, we could all just, like, we're all, like, hella smart about, like, one random fucking thing for some reason. It's just, like, that thing we're into. And, of course, if, like, I try to talk to you about your shit, I'm gonna, like, it's gonna be frustrating for you, because, like, I'm not gonna fucking understand it.
I mean, it wouldn't be frustrating for me. I'd probably just have to explain it.
But, like, it's your talent or something. Like, I couldn't even interpret it. Like, to the 100% level that, like, you understand it. Because it's like, then that's, like, your fucking forte.
Well, by the way, guys, I looked it up, and in the last, when Trump won, estimates show more than 58% of eligible voters went to the polls during the 2016 election.
So that's 48%. That's 44% that 42, maybe did.
58.
Oh, yeah. Right.
42% of eligible voters.
Yeah.
Because there's a lot of people that aren't eligible.
Damn, that's literally like half people did not vote. That's
more.
Yeah, dude.
There's a lot of people that are not allowed to vote. Absolutely. I was not allowed to vote. I'm still. Oh,
yeah, that's true.
I'll be allowed to vote for the next. I'm a person that does not vote. And I always. Part of it has always been, like, I can't vote. But part of it has always been me thinking that my vote does not matter, and I just don't give a shit.
Yeah.
Shit will go my way anyways.
But yeah, if, like, all of us think that way, it's literally just, like...
So the next vote, honestly, is literally just, like, a Trump thing. I'm gonna go vote against him. Well...
Unless the contender's, like, fucked up
shit.
Unless
the other person is, like, let's tear down all humanity and let's just all live.
Mass suicide.
Let's all live.
We all kill ourselves.
Huts made out of old
deer carcasses.
Plastic bottles.
To cut down on pollution.
Yeah, we're going to all live in plastic bottle houses.
Yeah. Sounds good.
Yeah, like.
If they say that.
But what would you do in that situation if the other side was so bad?
What would happen if, like, we all just, like, a hashtag trends on Twitter, like, vote for fucking,
we wouldn't have, the funding.
Like, The Rock. And what if he actually is the majority? Like electoral.
Isn't The Rock running for president?
No, like, I don't think he is, but I'm just saying,
I thought he was. No.
If someone won that didn't actually, like, officially, like, attempt to be president, what the fuck happens? Like, do we just be like, oh yeah, if you want to be president, like,
bro, there's definitely going to be someone to. They're definitely going to have candidates. It's not like they're like, we can't find anyone.
No, people are hella want to be president.
So, fuck it, let's so find
second
this
place
meme.
Would win, I guess, yeah. So that makes sense.
Dude, I feel like there's it would have to be someone really, really fucked up for me to vote for Trump.
Yeah.
Like, it would definitely have to be, because Trump is really fucked up, dude. Like, I know I said all these things about maybe Trump is, like, a goofy chill guy to hang out with, but...
Yeah.
The shit that he's done is definitely some of the most scummiest shit that I have ever witnessed. And, you know, I have not lived for that long. I've only been in America for Obama.
Yeah.
And then this fucking guy now. But the
and Bush.
Done,
oh, you.
No, you're not here for
Bush.
Bush. Damn.
For Bush. No, I
yeah,
came here in 2009. End of 2009.
I was here for Clinton for like a year.
Yeah, you don't remember that shit.
No, I had no idea.
So this, but like what I'm saying is, this guy is really fucked up in my opinion. He, the stuff that he's been, I don't know, the stuff that he's been doing is just very self-centric, I think, and very, just
non-considerate.
Non-considerate, yeah.
good word usage.
It's just very, he's just like doing things that benefit him and his people, kind of. And
yeah.
He's just being stupid. He just, I don't know. This world is just dumb now.
I mean, I feel like he is like hella trying to make it so no terrorists can get into the country by just putting all these bans in all these countries for like shit. And it's like, I feel like, is it really like those countries? I hear a lot of terrorist like acts of just like, you know, like maybe Mexicans or white people or just like they do that shit too. I don't know. Honestly, it's like, what is the actual percentage? Like, I feel like there's way more fucked up shit that happens from people that are already in this country versus like maybe
oh,
like 100%. One or two things that happens like every couple of years
all
from like people coming from the outside and we think so much of it.
All school shooters and shit, dude.
Yeah, like it's so fucked. Like,
but are you really gonna be mad at your own people or are you gonna get mad at the other people?
Yeah, like, cause I mean,
like
that makes
yeah,
it seems
yeah.
more fucked up.
It makes sense. It makes sense, but it is fucked up. That's
yeah
the point.
It's like I feel like if he put that much effort that he's putting into like these Muslim bans on just like, I don't know, putting that effort into like making our law enforcement like more efficient, not that it's bad, but I don't know, just into actually improving the country.
Yeah,
it'd probably be like way better
for real.
Dude, fuck talking about Trump.
Yeah, I'm done talking about this clown.
Yeah, he doesn't deserve all this clout.
Honestly, we should talk about weed.
Yeah.
Let's talk about some good old green.
I'm
trying to remember. Yeah, just like specific moments in my life. Like, honestly, like...
Honestly, I've
been not
pretty straight.
Not much. Damn. All right, well, I guess, like, yeah, for me, like, honestly...
People
like,
are different.
Yeah, I mean, I'm probably my memory of shit just like that was kind of ass to begin with, maybe.
Yeah, I already did have a bad memory.
Yeah.
With,
yeah.
Things when I was younger, but then once I started smoking, it became even worse.
Yeah, like, I mean, I feel like for me, it just fucks with, like, my sense of time and just, like, everything that's going on. Just, like, I don't know.
That's why
but,
I don't really fuck with doing it every day, but if you do it, like, occasionally, it's nice.
That's what I've been starting to do. Like, I don't know. I literally only smoke, like, on the weekends now.
Like, smoke only, like, when you can hang out with your friends.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I was like that for a long time, but I'm just really stressed now with what I'm doing with my life.
Yeah.
And just being able to de-stress with weed. Like, I'm using it literally as an herb, you know? Like I'm using it to just de-stress and relax at night and sleep.
Yeah,
so,
it definitely helps me sleep.
Yeah, so it's just... I don't know, like, I'm definitely dependent on it right now,
mm-hmm.
but I know that once I'm past this particular point of my life, I'm gonna chill on it.
Yeah, that makes sense.
I'm slowly starting, you know, like, I'm kind of a huge stoner. For a while, I just, everything I would do, I would just think, you know, it'd be more fun if I was high right now.
Yeah.
Like, eating, yeah. It'd be more fun to high right now. Basketball, it'd be more fun to be high right now. But now I'm starting to, you know, come around from that. And I see what people have said, you know, to me in the past when I would talk to them. Like, eventually you kind of get out of that phase. And I'm starting to come out of it. I'm starting to really enjoy things sober again. You know?
Yeah, like, definitely.
I'm starting to be like, you know, I want to, you know, I'm enjoying this sober right now. I feel like I don't really remember enjoying it sober, and I want to try to do it. And I'm doing that right now. But at the same time, like I said, this time in my life, there's a lot of stressful things going on. So it really helps me, my day-to-day life.
Yeah. Yeah.
But yeah, I'm excited. You know, at some point, I'm going to start chilling on it more.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Doing things sober.
Damn. Yeah, I realize I don't even know if it's like me getting like really used to smoking it and not being as sweet as I used to, or just me thinking it's like is making it fucking up my memory of just like shit in my life.
It's a combination,
like,
I think.
It's probably a combination of them both that make me like wanna chill on it for a while. And I honestly feel like maybe like the problem with my memory and overall like, state of mind, it's probably like not even from weed, so it was probably from like work and life.
Yeah.
And weed maybe contributed to it a little, but like, because I remember like I used to be able to smoke, and like I would be able to smoke when I got home from work and just forget about everything and just have fun as fuck playing my video games. But now, like, if I smoke or just at all times, like I'm just thinking about like so much shit, I can never just zone out on something.
Yeah.
And it makes the high like way different.
Yeah.
So
it's a combination of tolerance and just life being more stressful.
Yeah.
But then again, you do have those times where like that we just had, just like,
yeah, yeah,
having fun for no reason.
Yeah.
So like, I mean, I feel like it all depends on like what situation you're in currently. Like, if you smoke and you're having, like, a bad time, yeah, you might, like, dwell on things and just think super deeply into, like, issues that you're having. But if, like, you're not in, like, a bad time in your life and you do it, or if it's, like, you're having, like, a really good day and you smoke
yeah.
a little bit,
oh, yeah.
you're going to have fun with it. It all depends of, like, what state of mind you're in before you smoke it.
Yeah. And that kind of makes sense with what I was saying about how, like, I don't think weed was the cause, but as a result of my... just like my work being stressful as fuck and it, like all that shit just fucks with me, that would make sense that like now that when I smoke it's just like it's not as like fucking sweet and like I can just forget about shit.
It's almost as if you give it like a negative connotation, or not like a negative connotation, but like
yeah,
a negative association.
That's
with
what
like
I think
bad
it,
times.
Yeah, yeah. I'm just like, I'm slowly getting like way more comfortable with my life. I feel like that is one thing. Like, I've talked to my dad about, like, anxiety and shit, and he says, like, by the time you get in your late 20s, like, you're literally straight.
So, wait,
well,
so
not,
did your dad... So you're telling me that your dad kind of, like, agreed with anxiety? Like, he related with you? You related with him?
Yeah, like, I mean, not even that my dad was ever, like, thought he had, like, bad anxiety, but it's just, like, literally just... a general anxiety that all younger people have with life. I don't know.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, I feel like everyone is definitely anxious to a degree.
Yeah.
Maybe
yeah,
some
just
more than
been
others.
Talked about as much
that's,
as it is now.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. That's really cool that he is like that, because I feel like the general vibe, especially as a male, has always been like, what are you, a pussy? Like,
yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Because my dad smokes. Like, I feel like that is what, like, opened him. Like,
yeah.
He's just, like, one of us, but just, like, way fucking older.
I think that's why there's a big divide between us millennials and older generations, is that we're also, since we're, you know, we have to face so much more stress compared to them.
Yeah.
We need to, like, we do need to talk about it, and we do need to, like, face it more.
Yeah, that's very true.
As opposed to them, and they were just able to just be like, oh, like, fuck it, whatever, like, whatever happens, happens.
Yeah.
But now it's not like that. There's so much more consequence to everything that you do. You know, back then, you could do some dumb shit, get arrested, whatever. Now, if I get arrested today, I wouldn't get into dental school, which means all that I've been doing has been for nothing. Yeah. Which means that I would have to start basically my life over.
Yeah,
things nowadays are such, you know, things are so much more stressful.
Yeah.
And that's how it feels about every test. It's like, I'm going to fail this test. That might just ruin my future right now. But that's why I smoke. That's why weed helps, honestly.
Yeah. I feel like one of the points, I think, in that video I was talking about earlier, casually explained, he was talking about how, like, the baby boomers grow up, or the baby boomers' kids are what our parents are, I think. But, second generation baby boomers, I guess.
They're called Generation X.
Yeah, Generation X, yeah. But growing up as one of them, like, just their whole environment was just, like, I don't know, way more lethal, less than, like, anxiety, like, making you anxious, I guess. It was just, like, because, like, if you fucked up, like, your dad would just, like, fucking, like, slap the shit out of you, like, fuck you up. And, like, it was just, like, way more strict. But at the same time, it was, like, simpler. So it's why it's, like, less anxious, I guess. Yeah, I don't know. But that is one of the shit they were talking about.
Well, you're sitting... I feel you. Because back then, it was like, you fuck up, you're going to get smacked. And you learn, you're going to move on, right? Now you fuck up.
Yeah. Now you're on TMZ.
Now, think about it. Now you get a ticket, right? You get two tickets. You get two speeding tickets. Now it's on your insurance. And now you're paying for it for years.
Did they not have that before?
I mean, no. Think about, like, 100 years ago, you think they had
that. Oh, 100. Oh, yeah, for sure. Yeah.
I'm saying, like, dude, we're literally talking about a short part of human life. Even generations, like, before. No, I feel like your dad, when he was younger, was not like that.
Yeah.
And think about it. Now, everything just has such long-term consequence for us that it's just so stressful. And you fuck up one time on one thing, and it might affect the rest of your life. Why?
Because we just unlocked the internet. We don't know how to use it yet.
It's just the millennials. We're just millennials and we're fucking...
Yeah, we're like...
We're the first of our kind.
This is, like, fucked up. Like, it's
hard to figure out.
This huge, like, technology, like, growth is, like, making it hard to, like, keep up with it and, like, work with it functionally as a, like, society or something.
It's technology growth with population growth. There's just more people, so you just need to control it more, and you need to pick out the good ones better. So you just make up, you know, all these fucking rules and shit.
This really makes me wish that I was born in, like, whenever they figured out how to make society, like, be able to be, like, a happy, like, healthy human. Like, the nature would intend, like, if a fucking, like, the equivalent happiness and, like, contentness that, like, a fucking monkey would have, and it's, like, trees with its family and everyone else, but, like, as a human being or some shit.
Dude, I feel like that's pretty impossible. Like,
it's close to utopia.
You would have to be at, like, a specific place at a specific time in history.
Yeah. But, like, it wouldn't last, like, forever
either. That is true, yeah.
It would only last for however many.
But that would be hype to be born at that time, though. Like, not even that, like, the whole society is perfect, but even just, like, you know, like, the schooling system and just, like, the whole system of growing up and becoming an adult. And you're just happier, shit's, like, more efficient. It works, like, you don't have to worry about shit.
Yeah.
But,
it'll never be perfect, but, like...
Yeah. It'll probably, like, always be kind of fucked in some way.
Yeah, you can't expect it to be perfect.
Yeah. But overall, I feel like... So that's... I mean, that's what connects us all at the end of the day, is that we all have these struggles. And we all... You know, like... I feel like no matter what, if I could just link up with a couple of my friends...
Yeah.
Roll up a blunt, you know, hit a pen...
Yeah.
Roll up a joint... Do something, all of a sudden, watch, like, Rick and Morty or something. Or some just, you know, basketball game, whatever. All of a sudden, things matter a lot less. Because you just, it's that human interaction, you know, it's human to human. You just sit there, mm-hmm. and
That's important in your life to be like a sane human being.
Exactly.
Like, you can't just be stressing about everything all the time, like 100% of the time. You have to let go for at least some amount of time, or else you'll literally go insane.
Yeah, and human interaction is like super important.
Exactly.
And that's one thing that like, or like meaningful human interaction, like pure human interaction, that's shit that like we probably don't get much at all.
Yeah.
And that's why we're like, you know, it's just because of the social media thing, like you're scared to talk to each other and shit.
Yeah.
So.
And that's what makes things like this, like a podcast, so beautiful, because it's just people.
Yeah, that can actually talk, and they like, don't have to be paranoid about shit.
And it's not, it's really not super deep. You would just be honest, you would relate with people. Because even at work, you know, if you think about it, you're talking to people at work, you're to a certain extent, you're fake.
Yeah, you're putting on a certain persona to, like, match where you're at.
Yeah. Right now, for sure, yeah.
Right now, this is me, you know, this is
pure me, this is raw.
Raw nuke.
Raw nuke.
That sounds like a porn video.
Fully raw. Nuke. Catch me on the Pornhub top 10 recent videos.
Dude, imagine if you became a porn star, they'd be like the series would be called like Bitches Get Nuked or some shit. Yeah. And like you just go in and just like kill the pussy. Like, all right, you
nuke that shit. Alright,
let's talk about something. Like, scenario. Would you watch a video with your male friend, like if it just wanted to start with anonymous, became a porn star, right? But the girl you don't know, right? He's having sex with random females, and it's a regular porn video, but you know that guy is your friend.
I mean, all right.
Would you still watch it?
With, I don't know.
Are you asking me would I watch it? Or
probably not.
All right.
I probably wouldn't want to watch it. Like, I just don't want to see, like, a dick or something.
You know why would it be him?
Well, I mean, that's a possibility. Like, I just said a random name, bro. Like, I mean, we all know I want to
say dick,
but...
What the...
Bro,
bleep the governments. Bleep the governments.
All right, no, it's easy bleep right there. Like, you don't have to worry.
You better catch all of these bleeps.
Yeah,
you have to be 100% accurate.
Yeah, bro. Like, my address, bro. Social security. I'm gonna bleep all this shit.
Wait, let's not have like a minute of straight bleep.
No, it's straight.
Hell yeah, dude.
Then, okay, so would you? All right. So you said you wouldn't.
Right? I mean, if I got paid, like there's a gift. I don't know. I just don't. I'm just like not comfortable enough with like. You know, males just aren't comfortable enough with seeing each other naked and, like, chilling with that person. It's just, like, this is just not something you just want to, like, see the other person.
I mean, I wouldn't even say it's just that. I feel like even if it was, like, if it was a really close female friend, it would still be awkward for me to just be going on, like, a porn website and seeing them, you know?
Like, yeah, but they're a female. You could be attracted to them, though.
You're right. You could be attracted to them, but...
If you're gay, then seeing a male friend might be weird. Like, I don't know. Like, as straight males...
Yeah, exactly.
It's just...
It's different.
You know?
But what I'm saying... But what I'm saying is, even if it was a female friend, it would still be different than just, like, a random person.
Oh, yeah, for sure, yeah.
But you could be attracted to them, you're right. So you could watch it, but just the fact that, it, like, the male, you know them, and you're not attracted to them, and it's just weird, because you would just, like... hear their voice or something, and you just know that's them, and then you see them the next day, and it's weird.
You know what their dick looks like pretty well. And you gotta talk to them.
Alright, so how about this? How about if you had one of the Stars and Arms people, but he is fucking you, your dream girl, the person that you would ideally...
Well, he is with my dream girl? Oh, fuck. I mean,
no.
I don't really have like some amazing dream girl that is worth me like.
Yeah, me neither.
An asshole or something.
Hey, the funniest thing is you're gonna bleep that, and then they're not gonna know whose name you said.
Well, this is the Stoners Anonymous.
Yeah, we can have like I can have a private one that has all our names on it that we can all listen to.
Yeah, you can pay for
I can just version. I can just link it. No, I can actually do this. Just lock it and the only people who can see are if I link it to you.
If you pay like $150 PayPal,
yeah,
we'll link you the uncensored version.
I can make
version.
Some money by buy some new recording
you
equipment.
Names. You can get you can get Rich Royce's address.
Yeah, you can get his coordinates.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can
for sure.
Send shit to his mailbox.
But yeah. What the fuck were we talking about?
We're talking about.
Oh, yeah. Porn.
Before porn? Or just. Well, what were we talking about that?
Friends in porn.
Yeah. Yeah, I probably wouldn't watch that either.
Yeah, it's not what
I'm
watching.
Like, yeah.
Yeah.
There's so much porn out there, there's no point.
Yeah, there's no reason for me to watch this.
The one with my friend in it. With my male friend in it.
I'm very confused with the current state of porn and how like all this like
dude, it's all like, incest and
this,
it's very weird.
Yeah, like I cannot generally like think about why it's like that right now.
Yeah, that's very odd. I feel
like
that's
what
only,
happened
like, 50
to
old
make it
thing.
Usually I just ignore the pef the you know, ignore that part. But
yeah,
just,
I mean,
it's still weird. Like when they say, "Like oh, like
yeah,
you
like it's just
like
shut the fuck
like,
up."
Yeah,
like,
no,
big
I don't
bro.
Know, like, big bro.
God damn,
like,
man.
It's
what?
I know.
Why?
Like,
why?
Yeah, that shit.
What's the like? There's that many southern people, I guess.
I don't know. I've talked to this about like I think I was with another people though or some shit. I think it's just like. No, I remember I've talked about this shit with other people, like, alright, what was that? Oh, yeah, so, I think it's just, like, a level of, like, we desire, like, a level of closeness with, another person that, like, we just can't get from some random bitch or something, so if you say it's, like, some fucking family member, not, it just makes it more, like, intimate or some shit.
So I mean, yeah.
Like, not intimate as in, like, you want to fuck, like...
I've never thought about it that way, but I see what you're
saying. I feel like it's deeper, and
makes it more, like,
it's deep to a point where, like, you, like, people like
it.
It
makes
not
it
even because they realize why they like it.
It makes it more
shit.
Like a real situation.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna rationalize.
But if porn could just have, like, better actors and better acting scenarios, they could totally make up for that lack of, like, intimateness that you get from this incest shit. If you just make like a good script, like some girl with her like boyfriend or some shit, like you actually give a fuck. It's not just like some dude just like see some bitch and they just fuck.
Brought to you by incest.
Yeah,
that's our sponsor.
Hey, what's your guys' favorite porn website?
I fuck with X Videos.
I was gonna say that too. X Videos is the one.
I'm not even hip on that.
Wait, really? You watch Pornhub or you wanna...
Yeah, Pornhub is lame.
It's like, I'll go on every once in a while, I guess, but like...
I've been on Pornhub since like 2008 or something.
Yeah, that was the OG one.
I actually looked it up one time and I was on it in the first month that it was ever on the internet.
Really?
Yeah. I looked it up.
I mean, Pornhub's definitely straight. Like, X Videos isn't that much better, but it's definitely better.
I go on a couple other ones, but I'm not gonna sit here and say.
Alright. You're
that's been like my staple one for years.
Yeah. I feel like
sorry.
I've literally like I feel like I've been X Videos is just like the shit I've always like seen the most.
Now.
No, honestly, bro, it's literally better. But the thing about Pornhub, it's like it seems like it's better at like
Pornhub is like the iPhone of.
Hey, yeah, you're right.
Yeah, you're really right.
Pornhub's better at showing you videos that are like
their website is designed way better.
Yeah,
it's the iPhone.
It is designed in more of a way to get like just. For viral videos, I guess, or something. Like, X Videos is more just like a database of shit.
Database. It's Reddit.
Sure, yeah, you called that.
No, it's really not.
Yeah, it's not. It's literally. X Videos is literally YouTube of porn. And then, Pornhub is like. Spotify Premium. I don't know.
Spotify Premium.
Not even. You can get Premium, but you can just call it Spotify.
porn talk.
Our weekly segment of porn talk.
All right, so let's just, since we're doing this.
Do you guys fuck with pubic hair?
We can talk about that in a second, but let's we do some exposing. As a couple of us that have a companion in our life.
Yes.
How much do you watch porn?
Not as often, but like I still watch it. Like, it's still a part of my life. Because, like, realistically, you can't like have sex every single day. So like, if it brings you a little bit of satisfaction, then sure.
I feel that.
I need numbers.
I'm not gonna give you numbers.
Yeah, I was about to say, I literally was thinking that, like, Dom is definitely keeping it PC.
I mean, I'll probably, I'm not necessarily gonna, like, fucking, like, giraffe or something, but I'll look at porn, like, at least, like, every other day, I guess.
Just watch it for fun?
Not even for fun, just, like, I guess for fun. Yeah, I guess. I mean, not really, like, I don't know.
You definitely don't do that.
No, I don't. But, like, I'd say a few instances, like, I'm just tired and, like, no one posts shit on YouTube. And, like,
let me watch porn.
Yeah, I mean, I'll just watch, like, a porn video and just, like, be entertained because, like, I'm not ready to go to sleep yet because there's, like, nothing else to do and I don't feel like playing video games or something. I don't know. But, yeah, I'd say, like, every other day for me, I guess.
Yeah. For me, it just fluctuates depending on what's happening in my life.
I'll go through
like weeks where like I'm just get home so tired every day, like I don't even like think about it.
There's definitely days where it's just like I don't give a shit.
Think about at some point if we all get, you know, if you guys, I don't know if you guys, whatever you guys stance on marriage is, if you get married, how that's gonna be. Do you think you're still gonna watch porn?
Probably.
I don't know. Like, I'll be a lot older too. I don't know how I'm gonna be with porn when I'm like older.
Yeah, and maybe I'll grow up.
Because in a way, I was hip on porn before I was ever near any female.
Yeah.
It's like a part of my life in a weird way. You know, I feel like it's kind of something. It's something that's kind of hard to admit. Most guys don't want to, you know, say, like, no, like, I watch porn. Like, you know, it's not something that as a guy you're proud of. But I feel like it is for this generation, for us millennials.
Hey, one thing is how I feel like, do girls watch porn? Like, I feel like they do, but just secretly.
Not as much, still.
I feel like they do, but secretly. Like, they're not quite as much. But, like, they still hella watch porn.
That's it. Males definitely have a way higher sexual drive.
Yeah, that's true. General, that's very
so
true.
We just watch it. Can you think about how porn is? It's definitely more.
Oh yeah, it's very more male oriented.
Hell yeah, and that just tells you all you need to know.
Yeah,
it's mostly males watching it.
Yeah. So how often do you think a female watches porn?
Do either of you or something?
Like on average.
Sure.
Compared to a guy?
In the U.S.
It's probably like a... If I had to throw a random bullshit number out there...
Like half.
I would say... At most. No, I would say less. Yeah. So I'd say like... For every one time a girl is watching porn... There is like 5 or 6 guys watching porn.
Yeah, I mean, that's... I can't argue that. But that makes sense. Yeah.
Damn. On any given day...
So that probably makes it way more annoying when guys, like, hit on girls, like, because they're literally in the mood, like, 1/6 the time we are.
True. I mean, I know a lot of guys out there that their whole sole purpose in life is to just get pussy.
Yeah.
I don't have many close friends that are like that, but I know people that are like that.
Yeah, it's not the lifestyle that I'm about.
Yeah, me neither.
I'm not really into that.
Honestly, weed is a big part of that. For, you know...
Yeah, so what else would we be doing?
For a long time in my life, I had... I might still do, because I don't really know what my priorities are right now, but I had weed as a higher, you know, on a day-to-day basis.
Yeah.
Like, on a day-to-day basis, I would rather be high than have sex. Because I, you know, I had never met someone that I really, really liked.
Yeah.
So that it was just sex for pure sex. And I would not have sex that often. I got high all the time. and I had the option to be able to have sex. But I would rather just get high and watch a movie or play video games a lot of times, which is crazy. So yeah, being a stoner was definitely a part of me not being super into women in general in that way.
Yeah, like, even though, even though I haven't a girlfriend yet, I'm not super, like, wanting to do it.
Yeah, you're not.
You know what I mean?
That's, like, the problem with the people that, like, hit on all the girls. They're just, like, super, like, sex-driven for some reason.
Yeah.
So they're all, like, creeped out. But, like, I'm, like, super not like that.
Yeah, like, I don't know. Like, I don't know how dudes...
I'm not trying to bother you.
Yeah, like, I don't know how dudes will just, like, walk up to a girl and, like, know that they're bothering them, but just, like, try to push through that to get them, to, like, to persuade them to, like, fuck with you or some
basically,
shit. That's literally
what
they
do.
That's
what you have to do, though. You have to kind of
bother
them.
Yeah, I was gonna say, that's the whole problem with it, though.
You have to bother them.
Unless you don't have that confidence, a lot of times they won't even talk to you. Because they're, like, you know, they either are, like, who is this pussy? Or they're like, yeah. Or listen. That's not all the time. Or they're like, oh, this guy's too nice for me just to, like, have sex with him one time. You know, this guy's like a serious person. That's really nice. I don't want to fuck with them. They're not just like a fuck around person. Or you just seem like a weirdo because you're just super not confident. So it just doesn't really work. You know, you have to have a level of
like super not like. Showingly confident.
Yeah.
Obviously.
Which
confident.
Is not really humanly, you know? Like, it's not a very human thing to be super confident all the time. Like, you don't have to be cocky all the time. You don't have to present.
You don't have to be an asshole.
You have to be alpha all the time. That's not a very normal thing. You just.
It's literally just like guys and scaring girls and liking them. Seems like honestly, like,
in a way, no. It's a more biological thing. It's like, can you think about like evolution?
Yeah, like more
you
like
more
it's
alpha,
a safer
like,
the
yeah.
safer husband that can protect
it's
you.
Just
and
stupid.
Shit.
That's not how shit works nowadays.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I wonder. I mean, a girl's probably gonna hear us say that shit on this YouTube video and be like, "Wow, they think we're like retarded or something." I feel like there's so. I mean. I don't think they're retarded at all, but there's definitely just things that we can't understand because, you know, we don't have those hormones that they have and our brains work differently and shit.
100%. I mean,
so,
we were just talking earlier about how much it would suck.
It'd be really nice to have a female here, like, in the group that could, like, talk about their side of this shit right now. Like,
we'll definitely have that.
Yeah, that'll definitely happen.
Yeah, eventually.
But, I mean, it's also nice because I feel like people don't, like I was saying earlier, it's hard to make yourself go out of your own mindset and like your own world and look at it from a general view. So I think it's always nice to hear both sides
definitely.
Of every every story.
Oh yeah, dude, when I hear shit from you guys all the time that like I've never considered and it just like blows my mind a little bit. You know, like we all do that to each other. Just like small things, you know.
Yeah.
Every once in a while, not like
yeah.
some life changing shit, but.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what's so cool. Everyone's so amazing in their own way.
Yeah.
Everyone has their little like niche.
Mhm.
That they're like super good at.
But we're all stoners.
Yeah.
And.
Which makes us better at it.
Yeah, I feel like we're the first generation, like, since we were talking about generations so much.
Yeah.
We're one of the first generations that's, that, like, being a stoner doesn't mean that you're a lazy bum.
Yeah.
You know, like,
that's true.
I feel like I'm a very productive
stoner. Yeah, because it's so, like, norm now.
Yeah, if you think about it, I mean, just in our group, we have so many stoners that are trying to be doctors, trying to be lawyers, you know, like all this engineers, like all the stuff that people are trying to do that's very difficult and very, you know, needs a lot of intelligence.
Yeah.
And we're all doing it, and we're all doing it pretty well.
Yeah, like everyone, like the general thought of like a stoner would be like some dude that works at like Wendy's, he's like 38, He's been there for like 20 years. But yeah, I feel like, yeah, definitely. It's just like weed's becoming like more normal now, and
it's more like, accepted.
Yeah, like more, just more people do it. So there's more. There's definitely still those like lazy ass like people.
Yeah, definitely. That
are like not taking their life anywhere, and yeah, it's holding.
But I feel like naturally they're probably those kind of people anyway.
Yeah, and yeah. So now the people that were like just straight like successful like driven people are doing it, and it's just like, it's a pretty hype little thing to and have like while you're doing it.
It's like a hobby.
Yeah.
What's funny though is I can definitely see myself being a complete stoner bum. And that's how my life went.
Yeah. Yeah. That's true.
I can definitely see myself just being high all the time and not doing shit with my life.
I
feel like if you were to do that, if you were to smoke more as like younger, then yeah, you're more prone to that.
Yeah.
I didn't do shit till after high school, so that's probably why like I'm still like same, straight.
I didn't really get into it till after high school.
Yeah, because like your brain isn't developed and you don't really know shit. Like, I
feel like, and you're already doing shit with your life at that point.
Yeah.
Yeah. Unless, yeah, yeah, yeah. And like, yeah, it just fucks up your whole like mindset. That's why I'm kind of scared. Like my sister, she smoked for the first time when she was like fucking eighth grade or some shit. Like,
wow. Yeah, I didn't smoke.
I mean, at the same time, we have a lot of friends that are that did do that, and they're completely fine.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know, it's just
until after your high school.
It's just kind of scary. Like, I saw my sister drunk, and it's just like scary. Like, I feel like I fucked up or something, or like it's not good that she has this alcohol. Like, she just can't handle it right now. Because, yeah. I mean, but at the same time, when I drank for the first time, I was just over 18.
Yeah,
she's like halfway. She's like 17, like 3/8.
Did she get sick?
No, she was just like, she just seemed drunk to me. But that's just because, like, now when I'm with all my friends, we're just like, we can drink and
we can handle it a little bit
better. Yeah, like, the first few times I drank, I was definitely, like, yeah, fucked up. Yeah, I was
probably like that too.
So I'm just like,
kind of. A lot of it was down here in this basement.
Yeah. The second and third time I got drunk was down here.
This basement is pretty historic.
The first time I ever got drunk was in this basement.
Damn.
Same.
It's crazy.
First multiple times I ever drank was in the basement. Like, well, not drank, got drunk.
But we used to have some lit parties down here.
Just the homies.
Oh, yeah.
El Squadron.
Since this loud ass thing just came on.
Yeah, we should.
We should just wrap this podcast up. Talked about an array of topics today.
All right. We hope you enjoyed the first official Stoners Anonymous podcast. We're all gonna say goodbye now.
As millennials, I feel like we really talked about a lot of our struggles.
Yeah.
Today, 2018, you know, we got Trump to deal with, we got our futures to deal with, we got all this other bullshit that we have in our everyday lives. No matter what, just stay high.
Yeah, just stay high and just talk to each other like the way we talk to each other today. This is how you stay sane.
Just stay genuine with people. Give yourself a break sometimes. Smoke a little weed. And you'll be alright.
Rip the vape. Look at some memes.
We gon' be alright.
Alright, as always, this is Nuke. Signing off.
Blue Kodak.
Red Cirrhosa.
We out here.